What's up guys, it's River, and today we're looking at the best point-and-shoot cameras. Point-and-shoot cameras are really the best way to get the most for your money. DSLRs give you a stunning image, but are often quite expensive. So today we're looking at 5 point-and-shoot cameras that give you stunning and close to DSLR level images without breaking the bank. And we're gonna cover different types of users. Whether you're a hobbyist or a vlogger, or you want a pocket powerhouse, I have you covered. And I also included 2 really unique and interesting cameras that you definitely will not see in other YouTube lists. I wanted to make sure I kept this list interesting and fresh. Let's dive right in. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe for all the fun content we have coming out this year. We talk about camera gear here, from entry level to high level professional gear, plus filmmaking techniques to help take your work to the next level. As always, all of the products that we talk about today will be down below in the description for easy links, so make sure to check those out, and let's dive into the video. So the first camera on the list is the Canon G9X Mark II. It's a fairly affordable camera and it gives you great images right out of the box without any editing, thanks to the Canon color science. It's a great camera for anyone that's a hobbyist or just starting out. This camera has a 20 megapixel sensor plus a 28 to 84 millimeter lens. This gives you plenty of room to do wide landscapes or close-up portraits. The images that come out of this camera are stunning and they really hold up to the Canon brand. My only complaint with this camera would be the fact that as you zoom the lens in, the aperture on this camera tends to close down to 4.9 at 84 millimeters, which gives you less depth of field, and it's not really that good for a low light. But if that's something you want, there's a different camera later in the list that would be perfect for you. However, that's a really minor issue because this camera does have a built-in flash. As for photos, it does 8 frames per second with continuous autofocus in RAW. Those are really impressive specs, especially at this price point. When it comes to photos, you can easily tackle anything from landscapes to lifestyle to portraits to fashion and even sports and dance because of that fast shooting rate. And the video in this camera is no slouch either. It does full HD up to 60 frames per second, so you do get a little bit of slow motion with this camera. Overall, both the photos and video give you stunning image quality, and because of that Canon color science, everything looks good right out of the box. And the autofocus in this camera is spot on. Canon delivers some of the best quality when it comes to cameras, and the autofocus is no difference. The autofocus works flawlessly, especially with face and motion tracking in both photos and video. And this camera also has image stabilization, which takes out any minor bumps and shakes in both photos and video, which is a big, big bonus, especially for a small camera like this. Speaking of small, let's talk about the body and design of this camera. This camera is impeccably designed. Ergonomics on this camera are absolutely fantastic. The buttons are nice and clicky and they're exactly where they need to be. The touchscreen itself is very responsive and I can change all of the camera settings and the menu settings right from touchscreen. This camera is really easy to learn and very user friendly. The only thing to note about the body is that it does not have an external mic jack, but the audio in this camera is fantastic. Even without using an external mic, you'll get very usable audio. Even if you're doing something like vlogging or talking to the camera, you're going to get very solid audio. Sadly, the screen on the back is a fixed screen, so you can't use it for low or high angle shots or if you need to see yourself, but have no fear, I have a solution for you later in this list. And also, a really useful feature of this camera is the fact that it has built-in Wi-Fi and NFC, so you can take the photos right from your camera, right to your phone, quickly edit them, and send them straight to social media. It's a really nifty feature to have, especially at this price point. Overall, the Canon G9X is a great camera for everyday use. You get great images right out of the box, and it's really easy to just pick up and use. The only thing that I don't like about it is the lack of flip-out screen and the lack of a headphone jack. So if those are things that you want, plus a little bit more horsepower, the next camera is probably the right camera for you. And the next camera on the list is the Canon G7X Mark II and Mark III. They're almost the same camera with a slight difference. The Canon G7X is kind of like the Super Saiyan or the Ultra version of the G9X and has all the bells and whistles that the G9X missed. Both the Mark II and the Mark III have a 20 megapixel sensor, but they have a 24 to 100 millimeter lens, which is pretty insane range. And they have an aperture between f1.8 and 2.8, which is amazing for low light work. Having a lens with more range and a wider aperture actually gives you a more DSLR look, plus you get more depth of field, which is more blurry background behind people's head. Overall, you'll notice you get a much better image out of this camera compared to the G9X. However, quality in terms of color and sharpness is exactly the same between the two cameras. In terms of photos, the G7X Mark II does 8 frames per second in full RAW and continuous autofocus, which is the same as the G9X. However, the G7X Mark III does 20 frames per second in full RAW and full autofocus. Most DSLRs don't shoot at 20 frames per second. The fact that you can get that out of a compact camera is really impressive. And video-wise, it's kind of the same. The G7X Mark II does 1080p all the way to 60 frames per second. However, the G7X Mark III does all the way up to 120 frames per second in full HD. Plus, it also has 4K, up to 30 frames per second. The G7X Mark II and the G9X Mark II are almost the same camera, but with the 7X, you get a flip-out screen and you get a better lens. And with the G7X Mark III, you get way more horsepower. If you can spare the extra cash, I definitely recommend picking up the Mark III. Next, let's talk about autofocus. Canon cameras are known for having extremely reliable and extremely accurate autofocus. The G7X Mark II is no different. The autofocus in this camera is great. And the autofocus in both the Mark II and the Mark III is phenomenal. When the Mark III first came out, it actually had a ton of autofocusing issues, but Canon has released firmware updates to fix all of those issues. So I'm happy to say both of these autofocusing systems are 10 out of 10. And as for body and design, it's actually the exact same camera as the G9X with a few tweaks. Thankfully, they've added a flip screen that makes it way easier to shoot at low angle and high angle, and you can even flip the screen around to be able to see yourself. This is ideal if you're gonna be vlogging with this camera. Also, the Mark III finally has an input for external audio, so if you're someone that wants to put in an external microphone or a wireless mic, this is definitely the model for you. Personally, I think the G7X is the closest thing to perfection when it comes to point-and-shoot cameras. Everything about this camera is great. You get great images, great video. The ergonomic design is fantastic, and I love that flip-up screen. This camera is probably the closest thing you can get to having a DSLR in your pocket while also maintaining an affordable price point. However, if you're somebody that travels a lot or you simply want to capture your life from an interesting and unique point of view, the next camera is definitely for you. The DJI Pocket Osmo is probably one of the most interesting camera devices on the market today. In terms of price, it's about the same as most point-and-shoot cameras. However, in terms of features and what it can actually do, it's unlike anything else on the market today. However, this is a device that's mainly aimed at video shooters. What makes the DJI Osmo so unique is the fact that it has a built-in 3-axis stabilized gimbal, which gives you extremely smooth and cinematic footage. This will give you results that are simply impossible to get with a regular point-and-shoot or DSLR camera. As for the specs, it has a 12 megapixel 1-inch sensor, which isn't particularly special, but DJI has really gone above and beyond on the side of software. This sensor actually gives you 4K video at 60 frames per second and full HD video up to 120 frames per second. And with the additional gimbal, you have extra features like time-lapse, hyperlapse, and panorama. It's kind of like an all-in-one video production machine. In terms of autofocus, this camera does a really good job. It's obviously not as good as a Sony or a Canon camera, but I never really had any issues with it. The only thing that I would be aware of is the fact that sometimes I found if I got too close to the camera, it would automatically focus to things behind me. So make sure you like keep a healthy distance from the camera. Also, speaking of autofocus, the face tracking in this camera is superb. The app that this camera comes with really makes your life a lot easier. The app lets you individually pick out faces or objects and will actively track those things and move with them even when you're not holding the camera. This is a really useful feature for getting selfies and actually filming yourself without needing someone to help you. Lastly, let's talk about design and body. It's a very minimal design, however, it's highly functional. The ergonomics of this camera are fantastic. It's easy enough for anybody to just pick up and use. The LCD screen is easy to navigate and you can change most of your settings through that LCD screen. However, if you want to get a good sense of what the camera is actually shooting, I recommend connecting it to your phone to get a better image. However, the phone is completely optional. The camera app is really easy to use, and I like the fact that it has a built-in feature for editing all of the clips you shot on this device into beautiful edits for you. It saves me a ton of work. My only issue with this camera is the small battery life. However, if I get a battery bank for $20 or $30, it almost triples the battery life. Personally, I think this is one of the most unique devices on the market right now. And if you're looking to capture your life, your travels, your adventures in an interesting way, I would not hesitate to pick one of these up. But what if you want a camera that's an absolute pocket powerhouse? For that, I recommend the Sony RX100. The RX100 is kind of like the Lamborghini or Ferrari of compact cameras, but they release a new one every single year. So buying the newest one usually isn't the best value unless you just want to show off to your friends. I actually recommend buying the slightly older Mark V and Mark VI. The RX100 has the exact same 20 megapixel sensor across the entire line of cameras. The only place you'll really see a difference is the lens and the image processor. The 20 megapixel sensor gives you really high quality images and the built-in lens is extremely sharp. The Mark V has a 24 to 17 millimeter lens and the Mark VI has a 24 to an absolutely insane 24 to 200 millimeter lens. You could not even get a lens like that for a DSLR. They don't exist. The lenses in these cameras are extremely impressive. However, there is a big difference between the two lenses. The Mark V has a faster aperture, which lets in more light, and it's better for low light work. The Mark VI does not have as fast of an aperture, but has way more range. So if you're shooting things that are really far away, I'd go with the Mark VI. But if you're shooting things that are far away and in low light, chances are you work at NASA, in which case I don't think I can help you. I'm kidding. But it really comes down to what you see yourself shooting. As for the photos in this camera, you get a ridiculously fast speed of 24 frames per second. That's as fast as video. You will never miss a single shot with this camera. This camera can handle anything from shooting sports to sports cars to fashion to portraits. Literally, this camera does it all. But video is where this camera really shines. In 4K, it does up to 30 frames per second. In full HD, it does up to 120 frames per second. However, that's the same specs as the G7X. Where this camera really shines is the slow motion. In slow motion mode, it does burst shooting of only 8 seconds at a time. However, it does speeds as fast as 240 frames per second, 480 frames per second, and 960 frames per second. There is literally no other camera on the market that does this, let alone a compact camera. And one thing that really sets the Mark VI apart for me is the fact that it comes with built-in professional level cinematic profiles such as S-Log and Hybrid Log Gamma. These cinematic profiles allow you to apply professional level color grading to your video clips and really take your work to the next level. Lastly, let's talk about build and design. Naturally, because this is the Lamborghini of cameras, it's made of anodized aluminum, which is actually the same building material a professional level DSLR. So you can really put this camera through its paces and it will not break down on you. The button layout on this camera is fantastic. They did a really good job maximizing the little space they had on this camera. Also, this camera has a flip out screen to easily get low angle and high angle shots and even be able to see yourself. However, there is one problem that I have with this camera. Despite costing almost $1,000, there is no external audio input, which is really disappointing. If you want an external audio input in this camera, you have to look into the Mark VII. However, that's also the newest and most expensive version of this camera. The Sony RX100 is a literal pocket powerhouse with its insane lens and super slow motion features. If you're looking for a camera that does it all and does it with the best features, I highly recommend picking one up. But it's not the only powerhouse on this list. The next camera is an absolute pocket powerhouse specifically for photo shooters. The last camera on the list, and probably the most unique camera on the list, even more so than the DJI Osmo Pocket, is the Ricoh GR3. The thing that makes this camera so unique is the fact that it is a compact camera in its body and design, but the actual sensor in the camera is an APS-C size sensor, which is a sensor that you normally find in big DSLR bodies. Naturally, with smaller bodies, you get smaller sensors, and while they still deliver fantastic image quality, you get many benefits such as noise reduction and image clarity by simply having a larger sensor. The best way to describe it is the comparison between a bus and a car. They both have four wheels, but they're very, very different things. So with this camera, you get a 24 megapixel APS-C size sensor, and currently it is the only camera on the market that offers such a unique feature. And when I say small, I mean extremely small. It can easily fit in the palm of your hand, about the size of an iPhone 5S. It has a fixed 28 millimeter lens with an aperture of 2.8. The lens is fantastic for low light work, will give you plenty of depth of field, and really, the images that come out of this camera are almost indistinguishable from full-size DSLRs. And speaking of low light, this camera has really good noise reduction. You can easily bump it up to 16,000 ISO without any problems, and even as high as 20,000 ISO with just a little bit of film grain. And as for the autofocusing in this camera, it's really fast and really accurate. If you're somebody that's in run and gun environments, if you're a street photographer or travel photographer, the autofocusing in this camera will not let you down. And speaking of speed, this camera has a ridiculously fast boot up time of 1.3 seconds. It actually took me longer to tell you guys how fast this camera boots up than for the camera to boot up. This camera is really aimed towards street and travel photographers, people that want to shoot fast and quick and move on, which is why the ergonomics of this camera are actually designed for one-handed operation. You can easily access the shutter button and all your major settings with just your pointer and thumb finger. As for the build quality, this camera is made of anodized aluminum, which is a very sturdy and robust material. And I know in my original review I said this camera kind of feels cheap and plasticky in my hands. I still stand by it, but a lot of you guys got really upset with me. Now, you might have noticed that I did not talk about video in this camera. The reason for that is the video's terrible in this camera. I kind of think it would have been a bit of a power move if they were just like, you know what? It's a photo camera, not for you video people. There's just no video in this. Sadly, they did put video in this and it's really, really bad. It is like worse than cell phone footage. It looks like iPhone version 2. Do not get this camera for video. However, if you want to carry your DSLR in your pocket, this camera was literally made for you. I would not hesitate picking one up. Well guys, that's pretty much it for the best point and shoot cameras. As always, there's links down below to all the products we talked about today, so make sure to check that out and make sure to smash that like button. I literally mean break that like button if you enjoyed this video. It really helps the video out and lets me know what kind of content you guys want to see. Last but not least, make sure to subscribe to the channel. I always respond to my subscribers. So if you guys have any questions about these cameras whatsoever, or if you're still not sure what camera is right for you, hit me up in the comments down below and I'll make sure to help all of my subscribers find the perfect camera for them. Until next time, guys, see you in the next video.